How do you identify yourself? Do you identify yourself as gay, as bisexual, as how do you?
I don't wear it. I don't wear a label like that.
Okay, because I was just wondering, like you write for The Blade, and I was wondering how you feel sexuality is involved with writing for the gay media, or do you think it is? Do you think it affects the way you write about things?
Well, I don't presume to write for the gay, to speak for the gay community. I speak to the gay community. I take issues and try to inject a different point of view than the one traditionally held by most of the Blade's readership.
That's just interesting because I think a lot of people think of you as a gay writer, so when they read that, I think it might change their perception, knowing that like you're writing to the gay media, to the gay audience as opposed to for the gay audience, I guess, if you know what I mean. Like I think having people know where you stand changes their perception about how they read an article. Like if I was reading an article from Hillary Clinton as opposed to an article that one of my friends would write, it was a different perception because of who that person is, I guess.
Right.
So that's interesting, I think, for people to hear you say, to know that you're writing as like a voice to gay readers as opposed to like as one of them in the community. Because I think a lot of people they don't see that, I guess. If it makes any sense.
Well, I understand that, but one of the criticisms that my columns have gotten is that, you know, how dare he, you know, say these things, you know, he doesn't represent our point of view. And so I generally just say, look, I'm not trying to represent the gay community. I'm trying to speak to the gay community and tell you, you know, there are certain things that, for whatever reason, you may not have considered, some ideas and how others outside the gay community perceive you and what you say and what you do.
Do you feel it's possible to be religious and gay? Like, do you think that religion and that kind of sexuality, because it's so played up in the media right now as you know, gay marriage and issues like that, and it really kind of pits, like, sexuality against religion. Do you think that's fair? Do you think there's some sort of balance?
Oh, I definitely think there's some sort of balance, and people have to find that within themselves. If they're honest with themselves and honest and in touch with their spirituality, I think that those issues are personal and can be resolved.
What are your thoughts on the current state of gay issues and rights and the, you know, ongoing like gay movement? What are your thoughts about that?
Well, I think the gay movement is being misled. The people who have appointed themselves as leaders of the gay movement have allied themselves with people who have very little accountability and don't appear to have any intention of providing the desired results. And I think it's a self-marginalizing group. I mean, when you look at the leaders of the gay community, they've allied themselves with a political party that comes and asks for their votes, but never produces the results that they want. And so I think the leaders are doing a disservice to their constituency by not demanding more from the electeds, the people running for office that want their votes.
What are your thoughts about the transgender movement in our country?
I think it is the most misunderstood part of the LGBT. Frankly, I don't understand it.
Okay.
Most Americans don't understand it. I don't know how to change that. I don't think it's going to be changed by the movie that has gotten all these awards. I think there's a long way to go to understand that issue. I don't know how that happens.
Do you think that Americans would be, if it was explained or if people were able to understand the issue, that people would be more open to understanding it in general? Do you think people are open to understanding, like, trans issues?
I don't know. Honestly, don't know. It's such a complicated and complex issue that touches so many different parts of our society that it's a difficult issue to deal with, to be sure.
The Defense Marriage Act could be seen as unconstitutional, and if it's struck down, then it could mean that the floodgates go wide open for the conservative side of the House to say, well, now we need, you know, specific amendments to the Constitution, and now we need, you know, more protection for our states. You know, it goes back to the whole issue of states' rights versus, you know, national...
I mean, you're talking about one issue, and one issue only. You're talking about gay marriage.
Well, that one issue, yeah.
I mean,
But also, like, this controversy about hate crime legislation, and this controversy...
I mean, what about hate crime?
What do you mean?
A criminal act committed against somebody, what, because somebody is, somebody's motivation makes it a worse crime? Is that what you're saying?
Well, in many cases, proving, like, I didn't say I was for or against hate crime legislation. I personally am still thinking through that one because I don't understand how you can have specific legislation that, you know, based off of what a person was thinking at the time, changes the way that the crime should be punished.
Adjudicated, yeah. Exactly. A criminal act is a criminal act and should be punished accordingly.
But I feel in some places, though, it's more of a protection knowing that if you're growing up as a transgendered person in Idaho or something like that, knowing that you have that law and having other people know that that law is on the books might prevent them from hurting someone. And I think that's maybe some of the rationale behind it, is that it provides more of a disincentive to commit a crime. Is there anything that you want to say to your critics, or is there anything that you want to set the record straight on, or anything like that?
Well, I'm going to do a lot of that in my book. It's a little, there's too much detail to be covered in an interview like this, but one of the things I've maintained from the start is the important things to know about me. I am an independent conservative journalist. I always was, and I always will be. And my personal life has no impact on that whatsoever. And frankly, it's nobody's darn business. And all the things that have been written about me, posted on the internet, there's so much misinformation out there. I couldn't even begin to pick through it and tell you, well, this is true, this is not true. So, as a matter of course, I just don't deal with it. You know, I learned early on that you can't keep people from saying things, can't keep people from posting these things on the internet. So I just don't. You know, people are going to say what they're going to say, and I will eventually be able to present myself to people in the way that they need to see me.